Today's tutorial is a fun one. We're practicing our botanical painting and leaf design with a giant watercolor wreath. Welcome back. My name is Shady Campbell, and if you're new here, this channel is all about you and bringing out your own creative inner artist. It's about play and having fun with your art supplies. So in today's video, we're going to paint a giant watercolor wreath. Why? Because sometimes it's just fun to do something that's really big. So let's get started. Make sure you stick around to the end of today's video, because if you like my glasses, you can win a pair for yourself. Okay, as usual, let's start with supplies. I've taken a photo of everything I'm using because it barely fit within the camera angle. The paper was so large. But let's switch to video since photos are kind of boring to look at. So I've got my piece of paper here, a large palette, one glass of water. I don't need two because I'm basically working with green. I have some paper towel for blotting. And then today I'm using the Cottman tube watercolors from Winsor & Newton. The reason I'm using tube watercolors and not discs as usual is because it's so much easier to mix up a large amount of watercolor paint when you're working with the tubes. And we want lots of paint for this giant wreath. And then I've got some various brushes. I'll be working with everything from some larger ones to the very, very small ones. And I've got a pencil there as well. And then just a note about the paper, it is about 22 by 20 inches or 48 by 56 centimeters. And you can get large pieces of cold pressed watercolor paper at many good art stores and some craft stores. Now before we start our wreath, let's talk about how to paint some different leaves. The basic one that I go back to again and again is to start with a leaf at the top and then a stem, and then you add pairs of leaves going down that stem. And this comes together by using the belly or the body of your brush to drag across the page and make that larger leaf shape, and then you use the tip of the brush to make those delicate stems and to join them all together. And at any point, you can go off and add another stem like I've done here on the left, and then add another whole section with pairs of leaves. So you just keep weaving it together. This is the second design that I like to do when I'm doing wreaths. This one I would call sort of a cedar. It's sort of like an abstracted pine bough. And again, you're starting with the main stem in the middle, little stems going off of each side, and then you're doing this stippling effect with lots of wet paint right at the tip of your brush, and you can work that to make it any size. Now this is more of a pine bough. You start with the stem, and then you're sort of flicking your wrist and painting outward from that center stem. And you want to move the page so that it's easy for you to move your wrist away from yourself or move your brush away from yourself. Another one I like to do is berries, and you just start by doing these very perfectly imperfect circles on the page with the belly of your brush, and then you join them together with little stems using the very tip of your brush, and you can add some details like leaves, and you can see there how much paint is contained in the belly of my brush. When I want to do a larger shape like a leaf, I just squish the belly of the brush on the page, but otherwise I can use the very tip of that brush to just get the ever fine details. Now this one is slightly different because I'm going to leave some white space in the middle of many of these leaves, and I'm going to add berries. So I'm just doing a sort of a combo of some of these other ones that we've already done, adding larger leaves, leaving a little detail of that white line in the center, and adding a few berries there. But you can see how all of these are very similar. Use a smaller or larger brush, change the shape of the leaf slightly, and you can make many, many variations on the same basic shapes and ideas. I want to take a second to say thank you to Movavi Video Suite for sponsoring today's video. I think that the more time we spend in the digital world, the more we crave a beautiful experience there. And Movavi Video Suite is a convenient and powerful bundle of video making apps that can help you to do that. If you're a blogger or a vlogger, Movavi is easy to use, it has a very intuitive interface, and it's great for beginners and for making those daily vlog style of videos. Click the link in the description and use coupon code SHADA for 30% off your purchase. Okay, and though this leaf design is much smaller and I'm using the detail brush, it relies on that same idea where you drag the belly across the page for the leaf and then you add the stems with the delicate tip of the brush. And that's what my leaf designs look like there. I've got them in my little watercolor sketchbook. And now I can start mixing up some greens and get to painting my giant wreath. To set up my palette, I'm adding some mossy warm sap green as well as this cooler hooker's green. I've got some Prussian blue on there so I can make some really cool greens. I've also got a little bit of red. Red is opposite green on the color wheel. So when you add it to green, it gives this really nice muted effect. But you can see here, I'm adding a lot of that Prussian blue to a mix of the hooker's and sap green. I'm gonna tap my brush off, make sure it's not full of paint from mixing the colors. Then I'm ready to paint. As soon as I draw my large oval on the page here, make this very perfectly imperfect. You do not need to trace anything. Just try to make sure it's about the same distance from each side. But you can also work through that as you're painting. So I'm gonna get started here. And you guys, we've already talked about how to do this. I'm using the tip of the brush to make sure that I add these beautiful, slim, delicate stems and lines. And then I'm using the belly of that brush where I'm holding lots and lots of paint and I'm dragging the belly across the page and I'm creating these leaf shapes. And I'm not trying to get them perfect. Whatever shape emerges as I drag that belly across, I try to be okay with it. And I might add a little tip using the tip of the brush. I might add a little point to the leaf, but for the most part, I'm just weaving this branch together. I'm enjoying sort of figuring out where it's gonna go, which way do I want it to curve, and I just really have fun. I find painting botanicals, because the shapes are so organic, I find painting them really, really fun and very relaxing. And if you're feeling stressed when you're painting these leaves, if you're worrying about, oh, I didn't get the shape right, let go of that and really try to do a little less. Okay, and looky here, we have our giant piece of paper with one leaf on it. I'm gonna move over sort of to the other side of the page here. That was on the bottom left, this one's gonna be on the bottom right. And I'm gonna do another similar design. I'm not worried about them being exactly the same. If I run out of the paint that I mixed up, I'll try to mix a similar color, but it doesn't matter if the color varies slightly. And I'm just following that same thing where I'm weaving these leaves together. I want them to overlap. And there I've got two on the page. And that makes three, and then that's what it looks like with the fourth one. So I've done four of those very simple designs. I'm happy with where they're placed. They're not equidistant or anything like that. And now I'm mixing up a very, very dark mossy green. I've used a lot of sap and hooker's green mixed with black, and take a look at the color I get there. The black mixed in just gives it this wonderful dark, I don't know, very mossy quality. I really like this color. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna come in behind or to the right of each of the first leaf designs, and I'm going to do this mossy dark green. And you can see here, following that same idea, using the belly to create the leaf shape and using the tip of the brush to create those delicate stems. But here I've just done a larger shape with that nice white line down the center, and I'm just having fun with it. And I'm trying to get it to butt up right against the other initial leaf design, and I'm even overlapping a little, weaving them together. Not all the stems have to meet up or match or grow perfectly. Things can be very, very perfectly imperfect. Once I'm done my first one, I'll go up to the next leaf design. And again, on the right-hand side or behind it, I'm painting with the larger leaf shapes in that dark mossy green. And I just continue around the wreath. I go in the same order every time, so I don't have to worry about the paint being wet. And yeah, because I am overlapping and I don't want to get too many smears, although that's a personal preference. You could bleed them together nicely. And then once I'm done all four of those, I am using a Prussian blue, which is the dark navy blue, mixed with some of the sap green, so mixed with a nice mossy green. And it just gives a blue that's a little less icy. And I am using a detail brush, which is maybe a little crazy because we're doing such a large piece, a large project, but I am using the detail brush to do this very, very fine
leaf design, which is again based on that same idea of just using the tip of the brush for those delicate stems. And you're weaving all of these leaves together. You can see I've got some poking out from behind the larger leaves. Some of them are right over top of the other leaves. So I'm just having fun kind of making the design very holistic and getting everything to come together. And you can see I'm working on the left-hand side of the wreath here, and this blue leaf design is actually gonna make two of the initial designs meet up. So I'm not gonna have space in here for any other design, just in this one area, and you'll see as I move out. So I've weaved it together on the top near the mossy leaves, and then I'm weaving it together on the bottom near the cool green leaves that we started with. So because they meet, I want both of it. I don't want there to be any extra white space or negative space. So you can see how it's woven together there, and it all really flows. But we still have lots of room over here, and that's where we'll put a fourth design, because I do want to have four or five different leaves by the time the wreath is done. And there's obviously two more spots where I need to do my blue leaves. And excuse me while I just take about 100 hours and go do that. Just kidding. This whole piece took me maybe 4 hours. So it wasn't crazy, even using the detail brush. And that's what it looks like with the initial three designs all put together there. And then for my fourth design, I wanted to paint some pretty sort of silver dollar eucalyptus. I think it's the silver dollar. It's the eucalyptus with those big flat leaves. I've got a lot more water in this green, so it's very, very light. And I'm doing these big roundish oval leaves, and they all sort of bleed together and come together. Again, I'm weaving them in with the blue leaves that I just finished. And this one is really fun because once I get all the leaves done, I'm gonna add some little berries. I wanted to say beads. I was like, it's not beads. So I'm gonna add some little berries, and berries or pine cones or flowers or anything that you can think of are all things that you can add at any point, or you could wait until the end. I'm adding these berries right now, or seeds. I guess they're seeds on the eucalyptus. Seeded eucalyptus. So I wanted to add those because you can see the lime green that I used bleeds into the leaves really nicely, and it's just a nice design element. So I've done two of the eucalyptuses there. And then over here, I've flipped it around, so you're looking at the top of the wreath. I'm gonna break pattern, and instead of coming in right behind the blue, I'm going to paint on top of the green. And you can see now it's back over on the left. Sorry, I'm flip-flopping a bit, but that's because I only have so much space. So I basically have two major spaces where I can put a fifth design, and that's what I wanna do here. So I decided it would be worth breaking the pattern. And you certainly don't want the pattern to become too patterny. Over on the left, initially, we didn't have room for the eucalyptus, and that's kind of perfect because you don't want this to look perfect. You want it to look natural. So finally, for our fifth leaf design, I'm doing something that's between an evergreen and a tropical plant. I'm not really sure what it is, but I mixed a lot of black into my green. And some of the leaves that I'm doing here are actually probably almost black, but I really like that nice contrast. And then what you're seeing here is I have two major spaces for this fifth leaf design, but then I'm also weaving it in other little areas where I feel like I just need a little more fullness, a little more foliage. So here you can see all of the leaves really fit together, but by adding just that extra evergreen there, I get a really nice fullness to the wreath, and then bam, it's done. Boom, 4 or 5 hours later, done. but this was actually a really fun project, and it's winter right now in Canada. Actually, in PEI, we just had our first major snowfall. So this is sort of the perfect thing to do on a cold, snowy afternoon. Spend the day painting. Botanicals are so relaxing to paint. At least I find them so. Then you'll have a finished product that's pretty incredible, and it's definitely gigantic. Head over to my Instagram after the video to see how I used my wreath painting in my studio. And thank you again to Movavi Video Suite for sponsoring our video today. Movavi is great for beginners. It has lots of intuitive features. There's a direct upload to YouTube right from the program. It will format everything specifically for the device that you're using, so you really don't even need to know what that means. And it's simple to add stickers and titles and video transitions. So if you've got a side hustle that could benefit from a little bit of video or a little bit of vlogging, check out Movavi Video Suite. There's a link in my video description below. And remember to use coupon code SHADA to get 30% off. Well, I hope you enjoyed today's video. I certainly enjoyed the process, and I hope you learned something about painting these different leaf designs, because once you get the hang of one, you'll kind of get the hang of all of them, I think. And finally, if you would like to win a pair of glasses like the ones you see me wearing in today's video, these are from Firmu. All you have to do to enter is to comment below and let me know where you're watching from. I just love to know where everybody is in the world. Thanks again for watching, and be sure to enter the giveaway.